Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're covering Lake Jennings Trail. Now this trail is more about endurance, if you will, from the length of it and not so much the difficulty. It's really around 300 feet elevation, so pretty simple on that front. Now there's one really specific reason why I don't recommend you do this hike. It is very pretty, but stick around. We'll cover the trail and then I'll come back and talk about details, how to get here and other really important things you gotta know, as well as why I don't think you should do this hike. All right, let's jump into the video. All right, wrapping up this trail guide, let's get to the details. So Lake Jennings Trail is 4.81 miles. I'll confirm that because the website says 5.5. So I'll leave it up here what I think is the final kind of total length, around 300 feet elevation, and it is a loop trail. Getting here is pretty simple. You're gonna look at the bait. There's the bait shop, which is where you pay the $5. An important note, you have to pay $5 for day use. They give you a little pass, you put it on your car. Pretty simple. Park there, a lot of parking, and then you can choose to go clockwise or counterclockwise. Which leads us, it's a perfect segue, into details you should know about this trail. Generally speaking, you wanna follow the flow of traffic. And what that means is you wanna do this trail going clockwise. We did it counterclockwise. It's not as exciting because some of the roads where you want, again, you wanna follow the flow of traffic, it's a little bit up, not right next to the lake. There's also some blind corners that people will come through. It's just a lot easier and a lot safer to make sure you're following the flow of traffic. And that means you should do this trail clockwise. So that's the number one really important tip. Rattlesnake signs, they are here, they are around. Just be careful, walk in the middle of the trail. That's your number one recommendation for that. No dogs. So this is a water drinking source here for parts of San Diego. So dogs are not welcome unless they're at the campground, which there are many, many signs for. So just make sure, you know, unfortunate, but you cannot bring your furry animals on this trail. Most of this trail is paved, and that actually leads me to why I don't recommend this trail. A lot of it doesn't have an actual designated walking area like I am right now. I am walking on the road, on the side of the road. It's a bit dangerous. I'm not a big fan of it. Some pieces of it are really, really beautiful. I mean, walking next to the lake, awesome views, but overall, the fact that a lot of this doesn't have an actual walking pathway, not one I would recommend. If you wanna walk around a lake, Lake Poway's pretty close, much better for a hiker. This trail does have partial shade. I would say little to no shade, especially in the summer. Likely you will see some signs for closures. This is not for this trail, it's actually for a different one. I'll put a little bit more info here as well as the description, because there are some other trails that you could do around Lake Jennings County Park. Also important to note that the full perimeter of this trail is only open Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Before I forget, there are porta potties and trash cans all around this trail. There's no reason for you to not to pack it in and pack it out. I'll see you next week.